the daughter forever. What if this was that moment, that chance we're taking? History in the making.
Hey YouTube, welcome to week 8. It's crazy, kinda going by fast. Oh man, you guys, I am so sick. I am so stuffy. You guys can probably hear it in the tone of my voice. And it's crazy. I just can't breathe. Whew. But I'll talk about that after we talk about what's going on this week. So, 8 weeks. I am 8 weeks, 2 days today. So, I turn every week on Saturday. So, new this week. Webbed fingers and toes are poking out from your baby's hands and feet. Eyelids practically cover his or her eyes. Breathing tubes extended from the throat to the branches of the developing lungs, and your baby's tail is just about gone. In the brain, nerve cells are connecting with one another, forming primitive neural pathways. You may be daydreaming about your baby as one sex or the other, but the external genitals still haven't developed enough to reveal whether you're having a boy or a girl. Either way, your baby is about the size of a kidney bean, is constantly moving and shifting, though you still can't feel it. So that's what's going on with baby, and this is what's going on with mom. Well, kind of supposed to be roundabout. You may notice that your bra is getting more snug. Soon you'll likely need a larger size with more support. Rising levels of hormones cause breath growth. I cannot talk. Breast growth and other tissue changes, all in preparation for making breast milk. Your breast may continue. Darn it. Sorry. It's being a pain in the butt. See, then that's what happened. It, like, you click one link on this thing and it takes you somewhere else. Sorry. Your breasts may continue to grow throughout pregnancy. Don't be surprised if you go up a cup size or two, especially if it's your first baby. Keep this in mind and allow for room to grow when investing in a new bra. Feeling fatigued, hormonal changes in particular, a more dramatic rise in progesterone may contribute to your sluggishness. Nausea and vomiting can certainly cost you energy too, and you may be having trouble getting a good night's sleep at this point, especially if you're uncomfortable or find you need to get up and pee. So that's what's going on this week. So symptoms this week, I have tons of them. It has been a excruciating week. They're all horrible ones. I have been exhausted. And I know being sick doesn't help that either. It adds so much to it. You know, this whole time I'm sick and I'm dragging already from being pregnant. And I'm just dreading going back to work tomorrow. So symptoms. My breasts are still so tender. I mean, tender to the point where when I'm taking a shower, it is so painful. Sorry for all the sniffing in this video. I'm so sick. What else? Lower back pain, vivid dreams, I have a lot of burping and gas, what else? Nausea, but I haven't puked yet, so that's a plus. But I've told you guys about the nausea before. It makes me nervous because last time I didn't puke, wasn't nauseous. So this time at least I'm nauseous. What else? I'm so bloated. My stomach is extremely hard down there. What else? I think that's about it, you guys. Besides, like, you know, we all... Not to be TMI, but we all have loose stools sometimes when you're pregnant. So I've been having those lately. Constipation has kind of come and gone too. And I'm hot all the time. And that could be the sickness too. But anyways, I have a head cold, you guys. Horrible headache. Stuffy. I'm just dreading work tomorrow with this cold I have. So, yeah. It's crazy. I can't believe I got sick on top of everything else. Okay, so it's a long haul ahead of us. We still have till May 5th is when baby is due. I have an appointment on October 3rd. I don't know if they will do an ultrasound. It's kind of up to them. They're going to do blood work, you know, routine first appointment. They didn't want to see me till 9 weeks, so October 3rd is my appointment. I turn 9 weeks on, I'm pretty sure, the 1st. So that's exciting. Cravings, nothing really. I've been so thirsty and just to the point where I'm hungry, and then I go to eat and I'm so like nauseous and don't have an appetite. So that's crazy. I never thought I'd get to that point. But I feel like bad that I'm like almost like I'm not eating enough, but I don't feel like eating, especially with being sick. So hope little bean's okay. Which, wow, it's the size of a little kidney bean now. Isn't that crazy? So that's about it for this week. Kind of a boring week. Yeah, no, I'm sorry, you guys. Besides like the bloating, you know, I'm so sick of my PJ pants and normal pants being tight, and I better get used to it, though, right? Yeah, so I've been just lounging around in comfy clothes and just my work clothes, so that's about it. I don't think I'll have a baby by video for a little while. I think we're gonna wait to keep buying stuff till after the ultrasound. And yeah, so we're excited to get an ultrasound, but yet I'm freaking out at the same time. So I might insert a belly pic at the end of this. I'm not going to get up and show you guys. Sorry, I just don't feel good today. But I hopefully will insert a pic for you guys. And you can excuse my baggy, crazy clothes because I'm just probably going to take it after this. But I hope y'all had a great weekend. I hope none of you are sick like I was. But thank you to all my new subscribers, and I love you guys, and thank you for following my journey. It's really nice to have people who are there for me. All right.